Interfacing real-time clock RTC with LPC2148 microcontroller. PCF8583 is a real-time clock IC consisting of 8 pins, in which pin number 8 VDD is connected to plus 5 volt, pin number 4 is VSS connected to ground, pin number 1 and 2 are oscillator input pins, where external crystal is connected, which is of 32.768 kHz. Pin number 6 is serial clock input pin. Pin number 5 is serial data input output pin. And pin number 3 is A0, which is address input. It is either connected to plus 5 volt or to the ground. It helps to determine the device address. And the last is pin number 7, interrupt pin, which we are not going to use in our example today. This is I2C slave address byte, that means device address, in which bit number 7 to bit number 2 are fixed and bit number 1 is A0. That is pin number 3 of PCF8583. If A0 is connected to ground, this bit will become 0, and if A0 pin number 3 is connected to plus 5 volt, this bit will become 1. And the LSB bit is read-write bit. If we want to read some data from the slave, the device read address will be A3. And if we want to write data to the slave, this bit will become 0, and hence forming the device address A2. This is internal RAM of RTC at memory location 0, thus control and status register. Memory location 00 and the reset value is 00. We will keep this by default. On first memory location there is 100 second. On second memory location there is seconds. This register will count from 00 to 59 in BCD. Same minute will work same as seconds. In write mode, master will transmit and slave will receive. Master will initiate communication by sending start bit on I2C bus followed by slave address including read-write bit. Here it is 0 because we are writing data to the slave. Upon reception of slave address, slave will acknowledge master. Then master will send register address, that is memory location where we want to write data. On reception of address, slave will acknowledge. Then master will send data. And before slave acknowledges to the master, it will auto increment memory register address to accept the new data. And at the end of the transmission, master will send stop condition. In the read mode, master will send start bit followed by slave address including write bit followed by acknowledgement followed by register address, that is memory location from where we want to read the data, followed by acknowledgement from slave. And then master then will send repeat start condition followed by slave address with read bit and followed by slave acknowledgement. And after that, the slave will send data and master will receive data and followed by acknowledgement. And at the end of the reception, master will send no acknowledgement and stop bit. These are the connection needs to be done, and let's see the output.